A dichotomous key is a way to identify specimens based on contrasting statements. But how do you create a dichotomous key? There are three general steps. First, you need to analyze the characteristics of those specimens. What makes them different or similar? Then create those key based on those differentiating characteristics, and then test your key. Can you identify the specimen based on your key and back to those characteristics? So first create a list of what makes your specimen special based on tests or data you collected in the lab and research you may have done on your organism. So maybe you collected some data from the Berkey's manual. So put that data together. So we have our list of four organisms here. We know they're gram stain. They're all gram negative cocci. And we have a number of pieces of data on their biochemical tests. So this one, for example, is the phenol red glucose fermentation test. And the next step is to look at what makes the organisms different or similar from each other. So we're trying to select those tests that would help us identify organisms. And I've highlighted those in green, where the tests help us differentiate. So for example, in these columns with motility, all of the test reactions were the same, versus here, some of them were similar or different. So if we start with the glucose acid test, we can see that in the first genera, both of them were negative, and the other genera both were positive. So this would be a good test to help us differentiate between the two genera, since the genera have the same characteristics, but those species within the genera have the same reaction. So genera are different from each other, but the species within the genera are the same. So we move over to the right, the methyl red test. Our organisms within the same genera have different reactions for methyl red. And then similarly down here for the nitrate reduction, this test can help us differentiate for the second genera. So we're trying to make sure that we're identifying each specific organism based on its characteristics. So that next way to really organize our ideas is to make note of those distinguishing characteristics and organize it in a fashion where we can basically go from least complex to most complex. So we have our organisms. They all have the same gram stain and morphology. I just put those there again. But that glucose acid test really was the most broadest test that lets us make a first differentiating statement. Doesn't get us super narrow, but it's just letting us know that two organisms were positive versus negative. And that was the one that let us separate the genera or differentiate the genera. And then the next test that let us identify a species by itself were those next set of tests. So here, if we look at the first genera, we were able to use the methyl red test to know that one was positive based on that. One was a positive reaction, the other one was negative. If we get a positive methyl red, a negative glucose acid test, and it has this morphology, we'll know that it is this specific organism. So last but not least, in this first step, ordering those list of characteristics from most general to most specific is the best way to actually start getting ready to make the key. So having all your data organized is the best way to go about starting to actually draw. So we all of these organisms are gram negative cocci. So we want to be able to list all four species. And this would be at the top of your flowchart. We don't have a way to differentiate based on morphology. So all of this will be same. But really the second layer, right, the most general differentiating was that glucose fermentation. So it helps us divide four specimens into two groups. And then the last step, at least for us on this first key we're going to do together, we'll be able to use either the methyl red or the nitrate reduction to be able to further divide each one of our two groups. So the two genera down to their individual specimens. This is the end of the first video.